Γεια σας αγαπημένοι μου! Καλώς ήρθατε και πάλι στο κανάλι μου! Είμαι η Αλεξάνδρα και είμαι η δασκάλα του Do You Speak Greek. Today I am in my office and we're talking about the vowels in Greek, how many they are, why they are so many and how we pronounce them. I got inspired to make this video today by a new student of mine, my dear Melissa, who is very enthusiastic about learning Greek. Πάμε να ξεκινήσουμε. And before I go to the lesson, if you love the Greek language and you want to learn something new every week, subscribe in this channel. I upload new videos every Monday. So give me the motivation to make more free lessons for all of you. If you have a specific topic you want to talk about, write it in the comments below. So, in Greek, there are 7 single vowels are included in the Greek alphabet. And as we say to the children, τα φωνήεντα είναι 7 και φωνάζουν δυνατά. A, which is called alpha, A. E, which is called epsilon, E. The Greek alphabet is included 3 single letters which sound like E. These are Iota, E, Iota. Ita, E, Ita. Ypsilon, E, Ypsilon. This last letter in English usually sounds like U, but in Greek it's just E. Let's do a recap. In Greek we have 3 single E sounds. Ita, E. Iota, E. Ypsilon, E again. The Greek alphabet is included 2 single letters which sound like O. Omicron, O. Omega, O. Sometimes in a word we combine 2 or 3 single vowels to make one sound. In this lesson I'm going to talk about the 2-letter vowels. There are 3 vowel combinations in which the second letter is this iota. The first one, omicron plus iota, omicron iota, which sounds like E again. The second is epsilon plus iota, epsilon iota, which sounds E again. And now we completed the list with Greek is. Let's go again. Ita, iota, ypsilon, omicron iota and epsilon iota. All of them sound like E. And also alpha plus iota sounds like E. And now we have 2 E sounds in our list. Epsilon, E, and alpha, iota, E. Also, don't forget the 2 O sounds from the alphabet. Omicron, O, and omega, O. There are 3 vowel combinations with ypsilon as the second letter. These are omicron plus ypsilon, which sounds like U, U. Alpha plus ypsilon sounds like af when the following word starts from ku, pu, tu, gu, fu, hu, psu. Also, it sounds like av when the following word starts from a vowel or v, g, v, l, m, n, r. And the third one, epsilon plus ypsilon, which sounds like f when the following word starts from q, p, t, g, φου, χου, ψου. And also, it sounds like ev when the following word starts from a vowel, or vu, γου, δου, λου, μου, νου, ρου. Actually, we don't. But maybe you know that modern Greek comes from ancient Greek. In ancient Greek, all of these sounds used to be necessary for the pronunciation. The researchers are pretty sure that the ancient Greeks used to pronounce differently. I'm gonna give one example. So, which was the difference between these two O's in ancient Greek? The first O, this O mikron, actually means O small. And the second one, this O mega, means O big, large. So, ancient Greeks used to pronounce the first O, this omicron, like one in a short time. But they used to pronounce this omega in a long time. You need to remember that in modern Greek there no something like this. So, all these letters are pronounced in the same way like E. These letters like E. And these letters like O. Why? Because the language changed, the pronunciation changed, we kept the letters. As the researcher says, we kept the historical spelling. If you ask for my opinion, I think that this historical spelling is necessary nowadays too. If we didn't have all these E's, all these O's and all these S, I think that we would have a different language. My opinion is that we keep the letters, we keep the language. But there are short and long vowels and sounds in the English language. Imagine these two words. The first it is
ship
and the second
sheep.
Now I think you understand what I'm talking about. Imagine a baby starts learning the native language. It never starts to say one whole word. It starts from small sounds, and usually they are combinations of a consonant sound plus a vowel sound. Let's take three consonant sounds every language has. K, P, T. And try to make combinations. K, 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 Ku, pa, pe, pi, pu, ta, te, ti, tu. In another lesson, we're going to learn more combinations. Like, subscribe, follow on social media, and I see you in the next lesson. Γεια σου!